My life as a surgeon scientist is a balancing act. When I'm on the clinical side, I spend time looking after children who have pediatric neurosurgical disorders, such as hydrocephalus, or water on the brain, or brain tumors. The rest of the time, I have a lab in the Stem Cell and the Cancer Research Institute, and we apply a developmental neurobiology approach to the study of brain tumors. And that means that we like to take ideas from normal development of the brain and apply them to cancer, because there's a lot of theories out there that cancer is simply development gone awry. It is a challenge but an inspiration to take care of children when they're sick. Children don't have any self-pity. They're not like adults, and they don't feel sorry for themselves when something bad happens to them. They just keep on moving. And I actually find that inspirational. It's very easy to perform both jobs for me because I find my inspiration on the side with the patients, and I'm able to go over to the lab, and the people that we are all working for in the lab are those children with brain tumors. So it's not hard to wake up every morning and find motivation to do what we do. The concept of the cancer stem cell evading therapy at this point is largely theoretical. It's a beautiful idea. But now we have designed novel experimental models to test exactly that question. Do cancer stem cells evade therapy? And which cancer stem cells evade therapy? And how do we target them? The only way to do that is to actually treat with all the same therapies patients when they have brain tumors. And then to find out at the end of the day, what are the cells that have actually escaped? That will be a breakthrough. And that's something that my lab is working very hard to do.